Thank you for joining us. Auntie, thank you. God bless you. Thank you. Waiting for others to join us on other platforms. Praise be the name of the Lord. Thank you for joining us. We give all the praises to the Lord in this month of His power, divine power. It's all about God. It's all about Jesus. Hallelujah. The Bible says, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. And I believe that He has authored our faith at the beginning of this year, 2021. And He's going to finish it. No matter what the pandemic situation is, no matter what is going on in the city, in the town, no matter what the economy is saying, the Lord Jesus Christ is going to finish it for us. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The Bible says, not by power, not by might. Hallelujah. So it is not by you. It is not about you. It is about Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And that is why we are very confident, as First John, you know, says that this is the confidence that we have in Christ Jesus. So my question is, what is your confidence tonight? What is our confidence in this month of December? What is the content of our confidence? Do we depend on the system, or we still depend on man? Hallelujah. But thanks be to the Lord God Almighty, our confidence, my confidence, my household confidence, I believe the church confidence and our brethren confidence lies in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So within the few minutes we'll be spending here, I want you to know one thing, that your confidence really matters when it comes in the place of prayer. Hallelujah. No, that's why there was one time Jesus Christ took His disciples to pray. The Bible says that He took, I think, three disciples, Peter, John, and James, so to pray. And at the time, they fell asleep. And Jesus Christ was praying. And He came back to them and said, why can't you just tarry with me for an hour? And, you know, so that you will not fall into temptation. So sometimes when we pray, we have that temptation. There's some temptation that is being taken away. There's some temptation that stays. Yet God gives us the strength to overcome. No wonder Paul says that in these trials I've sought the Lord, even the place of prayer, that this infirmity will go. But one thing he keep on hearing, the assuring word that he keep on receiving, is that my strength is made perfect in weakness, in your weakness. So the Lord gives strength even in the place of weaknesses. And I pray that our strength tonight, we be submissive to the strength of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. There is a place in Psalms that says, the Lord is my refuge and my strength. So the Lord has been our strength. It will always be our strength for those that knows. And for those that do not know, this is an hour. I welcome you. This is Refiner's Place Prayer Mission. It is non-denomination, despite it is being organized by Refiner's Place. We have a vision and a mission that is to reach out to the world and to the immediate community. The Lord has given us three cardinal charge that we should take authority, that we should raise up champions, and we should be relevant to our society. And part of our relevance to the society is this prayer platform. Hallelujah. If there is no internet, then how can you be relevant? Hallelujah. Gone are those days that, you know, men travel from pole and, you know, from one point to the other. The Lord has given us technology, and he has given us, you know, a platform like this that is solving, you know, that is encouraging people. I've received a lot of encouragement, a lot of testimony, and my heart cry goes to, you know, one of us that indeed have been part of us. Hallelujah. She lost her daughter, you know, on Monday. Hallelujah. I just pray that the Lord God will comfort. Hallelujah. However, the power of God supersedes our questions. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. That's why we say serve God. Despite of all, we say serve God. Many of us have lost so many things. We have lost you. We have lost life. We have lost dear ones. We have lost things that are dear to us. Yet we still hold on. Hallelujah. We still push on. Hallelujah. Many of us have lost our reputation. Hallelujah. I remember those days when, you know, there was so much rumor in Nigeria back home that some people were using my own name. I mean, my own name. I'm not talking about the name of another. I mean, my own personality, you know, to dupe or to collect money from people. And, you know, and brother called me and said, oh, the voice sounded like you. The person sounded like you. The way you greet us, the way you flow with us, that is the same way the person flow. I said, it's not me. Hallelujah. So some people can be there strategically to, you know, bring out evil. That's why the Bible says the heart of man is desperately wicked. Thank God that, you know, the Lord have helped me over the years to build a relationship. If not, those people would have cut off their relationship from me. Even if it's not, they would have, you know, have the audacity to call me and, you know, and say to somebody, you know, call them and receive money from them, you know. And the person was saying that he's in Nigeria, that he's stranded. You know, there are some people that don't want your progress. There are some institutions that do not want your progress. So it's not a matter of praying that people should die or enemy should die. No, the thing is that it is real. When the Lord says pray for your enemy, he knows that you have an enemy. So don't disguise it. Don't paint spirituality to it. You have an enemy. But what do you do with your enemy is the question. Hallelujah. Do you hand over your enemy to God? Do you hand over your enemy to the judgment of God? Hallelujah. Or you fight for yourself. And that is why we've been running that series on efficacy of his power, the divine power of God. Hallelujah. The efficacy, that means there is no question about the power of God. If the Lord says that he will fight for you and you shall hold your peace, my brother, my sister, you need to rehearse that prophecy and that declaration every day. And say, Father, I will hold my peace and you will fight for me. No matter how the conspirator might stand, no matter how the problems might stand, no matter how men might demonstrate to be Nebuchadnezzar of my own time, Lord, your word says you will fight for me and I will hold my peace. That is the word that we should be praying with. And I declare that tonight, the Lord will give you that strength to make utterances. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The book of Psalms says, open up your mouth wide. Hi, God, we feel it. So tonight, do not be perturbed. Don't be discouraged. Open your mouth wide. Be bold tonight, because the Lord has not given you the spirit of fear. Who are you going to be fear? Who are you going to be fearful of? Declare tonight, as if tonight is a time of your consolation. And I declare it will be your time of consolation in the name of Jesus. Declare that indeed I am pressing on. I am going on. Thank you for joining us. Those that are joining us in other platforms, May the Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So don't pray it tonight. Don't say, oh, I thank God for this platform. We have not mentioned anything about money. We have not even said money. So money is not the problem. Hallelujah. It is just your commitment. It is just your moment of asking God, God, here I am. Hallelujah. Some people think everything that goes on Facebook or on the Twitter or on YouTube or online is fraud. Hallelujah. In this platform, we have not demanded anything. What we demanded is that you trust God. And that is it. And that is the gospel. Anything less than that is going to be manipulation. Hallelujah. So we have not requested that you transfer money to our account. No, we have. I don't think we have displayed any account number. Hallelujah. But what we have trusted people for is that they call upon Jesus. They call upon the one that is the author and the finisher of their faith. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So as we pray tonight, as we declare tonight, I trust God that the Lord God will go before us to answer for us. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Holy Ghost, do it again. Do it again in our life. Thank you for joining us. Open our eyes to see Jesus seated upon the throne. Holy God, do it again. Do it again in my life. Open the heart to see seated upon the throne. Yahweh, 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 situation. begin to worship the Lord wherever you are. Give all the praises to Him and say, Father Lord, you are my ancient of things. You are the leading of the valley. Worship the Lord. Say, Father Lord, I worship you. I give you all the praise. I magnify your name. I give you all adoration. You are worthy to be praised. Yes, Lord, we worship you. We exalt you, Father. Say, Father, I am here tonight to give you all the praise, to give you all the glory. From January to now, say, Father, Lord, I am grateful. I am grateful. Yes, Lord, we worship you, Lord. Thank God for His mercy. Open your mouth and thank Him for His mercy wherever you are right now. Say, Father, Lord, we thank you for your mercies. We thank you for your kindness. We thank you for your precious, gracious word of encouragement. Lord, day and night, Lord, we are sustained by your word. Can you just thank God for His revelation upon your life? Thank God for His revelation, His mighty hand upon your hand. Oh, we will not forget. Through hard and pains, in every situation, you have never failed. We will not forget. Yeah. is worthwhile.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. In December, hallelujah. In every month, hallelujah. In 2021, hallelujah. In 2022, hallelujah. We shall sing, hallelujah. We will sing, hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. We will share. Hallelujah. Hallelujah is a heavenly language. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Can you just begin to thank the Lord wherever you are? Begin to say, Father, Lord, hallelujah. I shall shout hallelujah this month. I don't know why this song just came in the right time. Say, Father, my month of December shall end in hallelujah. No matter what the strategy, no matter what the tragedy, no matter what the manipulation, say, my month will end in hallelujah. Can you declare, say, our month in our church among my brethren will end with hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't know the meaning of hallelujah, but one thing I know is that hallelujah is an heavenly language. Hallelujah. Hallelujah is an heavenly language. I don't know how you can shout it. I don't know how you can shout it. Thank you for joining us. Say, Father, in this month, December, I shall shout hallelujah. Whether there is food or not, hallelujah is hallelujah. Whether there is provision or not, hallelujah is hallelujah. Whether I am going forward or moving backward, hallelujah is hallelujah. Say, this month, Father, my focus is that I will shout hallelujah. Anyhow, I will shout hallelujah, no matter the situation. The Bible says, in all things, give thanks to the Lord. Give thanks to the Lord in all things, whether up or down, give thanks. That's how hallelujah is. Hallelujah is like you giving thanks in all things, saying hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Say, Father, this month, my home shall shout hallelujah. My brethren in the church shall shout hallelujah. Refiner's place shall shout hallelujah. If you belong to a church, say, Father, my local assembly, my local church shall shout hallelujah. The body of Jesus shall shout hallelujah. That nation that you are, say, Father, in my nation, in this country that I have, we shall shout hallelujah. No matter what the Omicron or whatever is the name of the new variants, Lord, we will shout. And let me tell you, I remember at the beginning of the COVID, and there was a song that the Lord released, you know, put in my heart that indeed we shall shout hallelujah. He said that, you know, we shall overcome even COVID itself. So that is why tonight we are just celebrating. We are in the attitude of celebration. We know that beloved ones have gone. But that does not stop us shouting hallelujah. That does not stop us rejoicing in the Lord. That does not stop us giving thanks into the Lord. Hallelujah. And that is where the devil wants to push us. That is where Corona wants to put us, for us to shut up our mouth. For us to not to even gather at all. For us not to even see one another at all. But thanks be unto the Lord. The Bible says, in all things, give thanks unto the Lord. Say, Father, tonight I am here to give thanks to you. I am a vessel tonight that will represent your thanksgiving. I am a vessel tonight that will represent the thanksgiving of the Lord. Say, Father, my home is a vessel that will represent your thanksgiving. Thank you for joining us, my sister. This is the hour to say, Father, my entire being will represent a thanksgiving to you, Lord Almighty. Lord, be thou glorified in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Be thou glorified in Jesus' name. We will be dealing with a team from now to the end of the year. Hallelujah. That is around efficacy of God's power. The efficacy of his power. That means the Lord God Power cannot be questioned. You can't question. I can't question the power of God. I can't argue the power of God. I can't say the power of God is fake or the power of God is original. One thing I can do is to submit to the power of God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And the Bible have made us to know that even we ourselves, as part of the creature, we express, we make known the power of God, the eternal power of God and the Godhead. Hallelujah. My life will reflect the power of God. Can you say, Father, thank you for making me a vessel that will reflect your power, for making me a vessel even in the place of workplace, in my workplace, in that job I am doing, in that career that I am, in that place that you have placed me for occupation, Lord, I shall reflect your eternal power in the name of Jesus. That men will be no without no excuse. Men will not say, oh, why is the power of God even in this company? Yeah, so far you are there. You are the carrier of the power of God. You are the reflector. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The Bible says, if Christ be in you, hallelujah. If Christ be in you, if God be in you, hallelujah. If he be for you, who can be against you? Hallelujah. So that means you are a representative. You are an ambassador. And I declare tonight, as you reflect this, this Monday shall be filled with rejoicing in the name of Jesus. On Saturday last time when we gathered, we really prayed about rejoicing's new song. And I don't know whether you have watched that clip. If you have not, go back and watch it and pray along. We made some declaration about new song. That in this month of December, the Lord will give us new song. Every day new song. We are tired of the January song of testimony. Yes, we appreciate God for that those testimony in January, but we want every day, you know, daily bread. Every day, daily bread. The Bible says when the Lord was praying, he said, give us this day our daily bread. So every day testimony. We need every day constant testimony of God's loading us with sufficiency, of God loading us with provision, of God loading us with confidence, of God loading us with strength, Lord, to move forward. Hallelujah. Of God loading us with the attitude to say, Father, thank you. So we are not ignorant of the loading of the Lord upon our life, spiritually, physically, and materially, and all otherwise, that indeed, Lord, we thank you, Father, in this month. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Lord. Tonight, we shall be making some prayers and declaration. Within the few minutes that we have, some prayers and declaration. Let me tell you, it is not the hour that is spent in the presence of God that matters. It is the heart that you use in spending that hour. Hallelujah. I have seen somebody that spent much hour in the presence of God, and at the end of the day, he came out being the opposite of what he has spent the hour for. Hallelujah. But that, I pray that this will not be our case, that indeed we will come out with a victory. We'll come out with a greater assurance. We'll come out being refined. We'll come out being bold. Hallelujah. Thank God. Praise the Lord. We shall also continue from that story of Nehemiah, because we still need to break every bounds of Tobias and Sambal of our time. There are things that stands as Tobias. There are things that stands as Sambalas of our time. So we still need to contend. We still need to break their bounds. Hallelujah. No matter what the years remains to go, what we know is that victory is ours in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's open our Bible to 6. Sorry, I will not be doing the much of typing today. Psalm 46. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Psalm 46. Praise the Lord. Psalm 46. 1 to 3. Psalm 46. 1 to 3. Hallelujah. Psalm 46. Glory be to the Lord. Hallelujah. Ekele dirigi chineke. Ekele dirigi. Unyoma. Praise the Lord. Psalm 46, verse 1 to 3. The Bible says, God is our refuge, Mali Yalaba, and strength, a very present help in trouble. a very present help in trouble. A very present help in trouble. My dear brothers and sisters, partaking in this holy prayer, a very present help, return, present, not past. A very present help, meaning that even at the present moment, God is our refuge. It's not only our refuge, our strength. Not only our strength, a help in the time of trouble. Why won't you be confident? Why won't you be confident, my brother, my sister? Why won't we be confident in the place of prayer? Why won't we say prayer on every moment? Some people are not happy that we are holding prayers every Tuesday and Saturday. Some forces are not happy at all. But that is not. The Bible says that men ought always to pray. That we are even having 2 days, forces are annoyed. What about if you have it 3 days, 4 days, 5 days? What would they do? Nothing. Because the word of God says God is our refuge. What is refuge? Where you run into. And you are covered. You are secured. Abalushada. The Bible says that the blood of Jesus that speaketh better things than the blood of Abel. Hallelujah. That is what we stand with. He speaks better things. So when the refuge, we run into the refuge of God, it gives us the efficacy of his power, unquestionable power. There is a music, there is a song that says, unquestionable God, you are the Lord. Unquestionable God, you are the Lord. Unquestionable, hey, unquestionable Jehovah Jireh, unquestionable, you are the Lord. Our Father is unquestionable. To us, is unquestionable. The unbelievers might question, but to us, as the body of his reflector of his power, we don't question, because we know that God is our refuge and God is our strength. So tonight you want to pray, Father, thank you for being my refuge. Thank you for being my strength. From January till now, thank you, Father, for being my strength, for being my rescue, for being my refuge, for being my strength. Let me tell you, Barak and Balaam were co-conspirators. One was a prophet and the other one was a leader. They wanted to curse the people of God. But thanks be to the Lord. With this full understanding, the Lord was the refuge of his people. He was refuging the people. Hallelujah. The people of God became a refugee in the protection of God. Hallelujah. He became a refugee in the power of God. That even the prophet that was hired, that you know that some people are hired every day, either by money or by kind, hallelujah, or by gift, in order to do you evil. Some organization are paid to monitor you. Some organization are paid to bring you to the place of nothing. Hallelujah. Some group are paid to make sure that life becomes miserable. Hallelujah. The Bible says that a man's enemy lies in his house. Do you know that there's some dangerous techniques are happening even right at your nose, unknown to you? But God, the Bible says that he is our refuge. When the enemy rises up like a flood, he is our refuge. Even when Balak and Barak wanted to curse the children of God, just because of the testimony that God wrought in their life, God was their refuge. Say, Father, I thank you for being my refuge. Even when sickness came, God is still our refuge. If you have the understanding that it is not about the enemy that we see outside, there are also enemies of our health. There are some enemies of our health that is prevailing at the moment. Say, Father, you are our refuge. Thank you for being my refuge. Thank you for being the refuge of my home. There was something I was hearing in the news today. Hallelujah, in the radio. Even somebody that took the two whatever virus vaccine still died. Hallelujah. So don't put your hope in the vaccine. Put your hope in the refuge. Despite the medicine is there, glory be to the Lord.
But don't trust in the medicine. Trust in the refuge, the divine power of God. The Bible says He is our refuge. Say, Father, thank you for being our refuge. For we are refugee under your power. We are refugee under your power. Thank you, Father, over this month. You have refuged us. You have strengthened us. You have empowered us. You have helped us in time of need. When situation think that we are down, Lord, you refuge us. Lord, you strengthen us. Lord, you build us up. Lord, you brought us to the place of lamplight. When people think that your home by now should have scattered because it took them 5 years for their home to scatter, or took them 5 years for their children to go their different ways, thinking that your own child or your own daughter, your son, will leave you at this particular time. Say, Father, thank you for being our refuge, for being our refuge, for being our strength, for being my present help in time of need. Lord, we glorify you. We glorify you that the church in the Refinery Place Church has gone from one place to the other, but yet the Lord is refuging us. The Lord is giving us strength. The Lord is giving us help in time of need. Can we say, Father, thank you. Lord, we appreciate your good works. Lord, we give you all the glory. Thank you, Father, for what you have done. Thank you for what you are doing. Thank you for what you have set to do in our life. Thank you for our brethren that are exceeding day and day. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. I'm so excited because the Lord is our refuge. Even at this month, this December, it will continue to be our refuge. We will not say that the December is the end of the month and God will retire. God doesn't retire. The Bible says, He that keepeth Israel never slumber nor sleep. Say, Father, hey, you will, in my case, Lord, Father, Lord, there is no slumbering because I know you don't slumber. Lord, you will continue to be my refuge. We will run to you. The Bible says, the name of the Lord is a strong tower, is a refuge. The righteous runs into it. Say, Father, thank you because my home runs into it. Thank you, Father, because my business is running into it. Thank you, Father, Lord, because my career is running into it. Thank you, Father, because my talent and gifts are running into it. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Good news. Somebody just wrote me and said, oh, can I promote this, your song? I said, go ahead. My song is a free. You don't need to pay money for it. Hallelujah. Some people, and that is our occupation. My own is a gift. Hallelujah. Go ahead. Promote whatever you want to promote. Give glory to God. Hallelujah. And that is how God makes way where there is no way. Hallelujah. The Bible says that indeed the Lord gives, never has sorrow. Hallelujah. Say, Father, tonight you are my refuge. You are my fortress. Thank you for being our refuge. Thank you for being our strength. In January, you are our strength. In February, you was our strength. In March, you continue to be our strength. In April, you were our strength. In June, you are our strength. July, August, September, Lord, you continue to be our strength. You never retire. Even in this December, Lord, you will be my strength. You will be our strength. You will be our strength in the name of Jesus. When the floods rise up, Lord, you are our strength. When the waves of situation comes, oh God, in times of trouble, you are our helper. Thank you, Father, Lord, for being my helper. Thank you for being my helper in the name of Jesus. Psalm 46. Verse 1, the Bible says, God is our refuge. He said, and strength. Hey, I'm not talking about, I'm not talking about six-pack strength. Hallelujah. Some people boast of their physical strength. The Bible says that physical strength are little, but the spiritual strength, the spiritual exercise profit much. So we are not talking about those that have Akbobi, as my people will say, or people that have, that have chest out. No, the Lord is our strength, like David. David, the Lord became his strength when he was facing Goliath. David did not have six pack, but David had the strength of God, the name of God. He recognized the personality of God. He never had confidence in his physical strength, even when Saul gave him all the apparel of a helmet and the weapon of war. David never boasted in those equipment. Some of us, because we don't have gadget, we don't have phone, we don't have this, we don't have car, we begin to limit the strength of God. I have seen a woman that has no womb written in, certified in the certificate that womb is gone, but the Lord gave her Oh my lagasa kalaba. There is nothing difficult for God. Don't limit God based on the things that you are saying. The strength that the Lord is talking about is not the strength that you can lift up and every duty. So no, it is beyond that. The strength that comes within that strengthens you, even when the devil is watching to stifle you, to kill you, or to destroy you. He's still watching to see whether you are down, whether you are cast out, whether you are passed away. Hallelujah. The Lord becomes your strength. You come back alive. The Bible says, though the righteous man falls 7 times, he will rise up. Because at the strength that the Lord, that the psalmist is talking about, the strength to rise up again and say, Father, I was down. Now I am rising. Now I am on top. Lord of the game. I am on top of my prayer life. I am on top of my giving life. I am on top of my evangelical life. I am on top of my marriage. I am on top of my relationship with men. I am on top of my ministry. I am on top of my occupation, my business. I am on top, hallelujah, of my spiritual progress, my development. Lord, I am on top of my mental health. There are so many people, even in this developing country, that are passing through mental health problems, so increasing, maybe because of the up and downs, putting their focus or their attention, full attention on the system. I tell you, if you put your strength on the human standard, there will be mental health that will need starting. Or you put your confidence in man, definitely there's no way that mental health will not visit the person. But when you rely on God, even when somebody is telling you that I will give you this thing, but inside of you, you know that this person is just lying. You know that this person wants to trick. You know that this person wants to, you know, use flattering words, you know, to just praise you. Even when you know that somebody is saying, oh, you are doing great in him, he knows that this person is not saying the truth. Hallelujah. And you want to depend on such, you want to put your trust on such. Hallelujah. Definitely when the person disappoints, the person will become, you know, derailed in his emotion. But when you put your trust, even when man say yes, that does not mean that you should put your trust in what man is saying yes. Hallelujah. There's a level of friendship and the level of trust. Hallelujah. But the Bible said those that trust in the Lord, hey, shall renew their strength. Those that put their trust in the Lord. Say, Father, Lord, thank you. Lord, that you have been my refuge. You have been our refuge. You have been our refuge. In the time of need, you have been our help. In the time of trouble, you have been our help. Glory be to your name. Glory be to your name. In verse 2 of Psalm 46, the Bible says, Therefore will not we fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. He said in verse 3, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, Selah. He said, we will not be afraid. I will not be afraid. The Bible said, though the mountains shakes. There are so many mountains, things in and around us now. COVID is my part of a mountain that is shaking now, shaking the policy makers, shaking the government, shaking families. Hallelujah. And the word of God says, because the Lord is my strength, is my refuge, a present help in time of me, I will not be afraid. I will not be afraid. Say, Father, my fear is not my portion. In this mode of your power, strength is not our portion. In my marriage, in my family, among my brethren, among my sisters, among my brothers, in this nation, fear is not my portion. Fear is not our portion. Among the elders in the church, among the deacons, among the pastors, the ministers, fear is not our portion. Hallelujah. Among the youths, hallelujah, fear is not our portion. Lord, you are our refuge. Our trust lies in you. Can you begin to declare it? Say, my trust lies in the Lord. My trust lies in the Lord. Say it loud and clear. My trust lies in the Lord. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. We read another scripture, Ezra chapter 3, verse 11. Hallelujah. Glory be to the name of the Lord. Ezra. Hallelujah. Glory be to the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be. Ezra chapter 3, verse 11. If you are there, glory be to the Lord. Glory be to the Lord. If you are there, sorry for those that want to join us. I was carried away by the prayers. Hallelujah. Thank you for joining us. May the Lord bless you in the name of Jesus.